string variables x and y are declared. In addition, integer variables I and n are declared. The printf statement asks the user to enter the value for n. Whatever user enters, the same will be read into the variable n. A for loop is written such a way that it executes for n times. I is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. They are the loop control statements. We know already that they execute the block of statements for n times. Already we have understood that we wanted to read each time a string and then compare with the string in Y, and the new string comes first in the alphabetical order. This one will be copied into the Y. Thus, always Y contains the string which comes first in the alphabetical order. However, first time whatever we enter, it will be blindly copied to Y. Once we come out from the for loop, the variable y contains the string which comes first in the alphabetical order compared to all the other strings. The same will be printed with the printf statement. Let us try to simulate this program. Let we assume that the user has entered n value as 5. I value is initialized to 0. The for condition is tested now. I, is it less than n? 0 less than 5? Yes. Thus the loop is going to get executed once. Let's assume that the user has entered the string RAM. Thus x value becomes RAM. Now, the if condition will be tested. Currently, what is the value of I? 0. I, is it equal to 0? Yes. Thus, first condition itself is true. Of course, the second condition strcmp will not be evaluated. Remember our discussion on logical OR in the first module. While evaluating the logical OR operator, if the first operand itself is true, second operand will not be evaluated. Thus, the first condition itself is true now. Thus, whatever is available in X, that will be copied into Y with the help of strcpy function. Thus, Y value becomes RAM. However, remember, this condition I is equal to 0 is true only for this iteration. Next iteration onwards, this is bound to be false. Thus, next iteration onwards, only the strcmp function is going to get executed. Or rather, the one which is going to decide whether the if condition is true or false. I value will be incremented by 1. Now, for condition is tested. I, is it less than n? 1 less than 5? Yes. Thus, the loop is going to get executed once more. Let us assume that this time the user has entered the string Rajani. Thus, x value becomes Rajani. Now, if condition will be executed. The first part of the if condition, I is it equal to 0, that is false, as I value is 1. Now the second part is evaluated. Y value is Ram. The new string is Rajani that is available in X. As this new string comes first in the alphabetical order compared to Ram, the strcmp function returns a positive number which will be greater than 0. Thus the if condition becomes true. Thus the strcpy function copies x value that is Rajani into the variable y. Thus y value becomes Rajani. I value will be incremented by 1. The for condition is now again tested. I, is it less than n? 2, is it less than 5? Yes. Thus the loop is going to get executed once more. Let us assume that the user has entered the string Ravi this time. Thus x value becomes Ravi. Now if condition will be executed. I, is it equal to 0? That is 2. Is it equal to 0? No. Now strcmp will be executed. Currently y value is Rajani, x value is Ravi. Strcmp y comma x, as Rajani, that is the first string itself coming first in the alphabetical order, we will be getting a negative number. The negative number will not be greater than 0. Thus the if condition totally becomes false. Thus nothing will be executed. I value will be incremented by 1. Again for condition will be tested. I, is it less than n? That is 3. Is it less than 5? Yes. Thus the loop is going to get executed once more. Let us assume that this time the user has entered the string Abhi. Thus x value becomes Abhi. Now the if condition will be tested. I, is it equal to 0? No. Strcmp condition is evaluated now. Y value is Rajani, x value is Abhi. Strcmp y comma x, as Abhi comes first in the alphabetical order compared to Rajani, it returns a positive number. Thus the condition becomes true. Thus x value Abhi will be copied into y. I value will be incremented by 1. Again for condition will be tested. That is it less than n? 4, less than 5? Yes. Thus the loop is going to get executed once more. Let us assume that this time the user has entered the string Anuj. Thus x value becomes Anuj. The if condition will be again executed. I, is it equal to 0? No. The strcmp y comma x, is it greater than 0? Currently y is Abhi, x is Anuj. Strcmp Abhi comma Anuj, when we send, as Abhi comes first in the alphabetical order, that is first string comes first in the alphabetical order, it returns a negative number. Thus it will not be greater than 0. Thus if condition will be false. Thus y value will not be getting changed.
I value will be incremented by 1.
Now again the for condition is tested. I, is it less than n? That is 5. Less than 5? No. Thus we'll come out from the for loop. By now we have read 5 strings and we have got the string which comes first in the alphabetical order into the string variable y. The same will be printed with the help of the last printf statement.